In this function, we are asked, in this problem, we are asked to find the value of some composition of functions, both functions and their inverses. First of all, let's find g of f inverse of 1. Well, the first thing we have to do is find out what f inverse of 1 is. So let's remember that f inverse of 1 will be some number a if and only if f of a is 1. So I want to find out what a is, and I know that f of a is 1. So I'll come over here and say, well, if f of a is 1, then where it came from is 4. So a must be 4. F of 4 is 1. So the original problem now says find g of f inverse of 1, which is 4. Well, now I look under the g column, the function g, and I see, how do I find g of 4? Now, 4 is not on this list. So g of 4 does not exist. Or in other words, we cannot do this problem. The second problem asked us to find f inverse of g inverse of 3. Again, working from the inside out, if g inverse of 3 is some number b, that means g of b must be 3. So if we look at this table and find the number 3, we see that g of 2 is 3. So that b must be 2. So we're then asked to find f inverse of 2. Again, doing this whole thing again, f inverse of 2 is some number, call it capital A, if and only if f of capital A is 2. If we go back to the F chart, if the output is 2, the input must be 5, so A must be 5. So F inverse of 2 is in fact 5. So the final answer to this problem is 5.